Steve Lillywhite. Why make a documentary about Steve Lillywhite? Three reasons. Steve Lillywhite is an international man of mystery. One day he's backstage at the Grammys, the next he's emerging from an Indonesian rainforest.
Hopefully this film will be something that my children and grandchildren can watch when I'm long gone, and or anyone can watch.
Tell me when it all started.
It all started about 40 years ago in a recording studio not too far from here, in the centre of London, in a place called Marble Arch, where a young boy who just walked out of school, had no idea what he wanted to do, walked in and managed to get a job. I didn't really know what I wanted to do, except I loved music. I was just 17 years old, and it was fear, really. It was fear that I couldn't do anything else. I went from being the uncool kid, because, you know, with a name like Lillywhite, when you're at school, you really don't have many cool points.
Two, Steve Lillywhite looks great on camera. That smile, those ears. Those ears hear things that other ears cannot hear.
Kings and Queens by 30 Seconds to Mars. I listened to this song and it was, to be honest, it was all over the place. And it needed some major surgery. And I'm very proud of what I've done, because I really molded that song. I changed the chords in the verse.
Three, Steve Lillywhite's got loads of famous friends that really, really love him, would do anything for him.
This house has lots of memories. I remember introducing Keith Richards of the Rolling Stones to Johnny Marr of the Smiths in the other room there, and we were up all night, and I remember Johnny was playing some riffs, and they were jamming together, with Kirsty was singing, my wife at the time, and they were both singing as well. Keith loved singing. And I was recording it. I have no idea where that recording is. Can you believe that? Keith Richards and Johnny Marr jamming. And I don't have the tape. That would be gold now. Gold, I tell you. This is my favorite. This is actually Keith Richards and Mick Jagger, but Ronnie Wood has painted over Mick Jagger to make him look like Ronnie Wood. It's funny, someone said to Bono, I said to Bono once, I said, Bono, you know, I know I'm a nice bloke and I know you like me, but you're not an idiot. You asked me back, you asked me to come and keep working with you. What is it that you like about me? And he said, Steve, there's one word, clarity. And that's weird, because I've never really thought I had clarity, because my head was always in the clouds. I never thought I had clarity.
Anything else?